Hello and welcome to yet another video. Today we have a really beautiful board. This is a Tough Gaming X570 Plus Wi-Fi from Asus. And this board came to me for a no boot condition. So it seemed to react to the power button but doesn't start up. Let's see, this thing has LEDs for power up. And I can already see, oh no, I thought these are scratches, but I think there's a lot of thermal paste maybe. Okay, let's just see how this board reacts. Let's put power to it, put a CPU into here and see what this board does. So let's see, power. This is very low power consumption, only 75 milliamps, especially for a board like this. I would expect that there's also like there's also lights on this which would light up. Pretty sure that this is supposed to be lighting up, but it might only light up at startup. So let's see. And it seems like we have no reaction to the power button. Yup. Let's see for the voltage, if we have voltage on the power button then. Let's see now. We do have 3.3 volts. Okay. So, if we have 3.3 volts on the chip, on the pin, and we have no reaction, I would go ahead and see around the SIO if there's anything there. I would expect a knocked off component. So let's go around under the microscope and then first see around the SIO, and we might have to take a look also around the CPU socket. Maybe there's something knocked off there. So now under the microscope, and let's have a good look around here. I can already see some scratches. I'm not too sure if this big component here is supposed to be there or not. Like the upper pads kind of look like there once was a component there. Interesting. I would have to look at the board view. Because you can see scratches right there and more scratches here. Question also is at the top left here. Let's get a tweezers in here. If there or there was a component, we will have to find that out. Let's continue our search.
Is something broken here? Let's just start. This also looks like this was damaged here.
It's quite hard to say. There's nothing decisively wrong. Interesting. Okay. So I couldn't find anything obvious around here. I will have to check a board view, but let's do that later. Oh, I just noticed. Oh, never mind. I think I overlooked that before. There's supposed to be a component here, right? Yeah, pretty sure that is knocked off. Yep. Let's see from a side view. Pretty sure there was a component there at one time. Okay, now I will definitely have to get a board view for this to check out what is supposed to be there. So let's do that now. So currently in the board view, we have this 0-ohm resistor that is connected to line 1 isolate. So this is an audio IC, I'm pretty sure, or LAN IC. And I don't think that this is why our board isn't starting. Pretty sure. Like this is connected to the SIO, but I don't think that this will have to do anything with our board not starting up. Let's solder the resistor on, but I'm pretty sure it's not going to change anything. So let's prepare our place here to get a resistor in here again. Let's put on some flux. Let's get some leaded solder onto here. And let's get a resistor on here. There's our resistor. Let's get one side tacked onto here. Just like that. And let's now hot air it on so it's connected on both sides. That was too much. Like that. Now the resistor is in place. But pretty sure that did not solve our problem. So let's see. We still have basically the same power consumption. And we still have no reaction to the power button. Like I thought it would be. Okay. But this is a pretty good indication that there must be something more wrong with this board. Like that there's more knocked off components here. Other than the one that we found. And I will definitely will check the board view now for the components around the SIO. So I found one thing, which is this. Look at this. I thought this might be knocked off, but this is not assembled, as you can see. But this resistor right here is supposed to be a 0-ohm resistor responsible for deep S5, so a sleep state. And this might be a cause for our problem. The pad really doesn't look like that it was ever like connected or not. Like if you look at the microscope, it really doesn't look like there was supposed to be a component ever there. Like usually they look a lot different when there's a component knocked off from there. But these two pads don't look like there was something ever here. So yeah, I won't be fitting that. Because I'm not sure that I'm reading this schematic here, right? So we're going to leave it for now. And we will be looking for other stuff knocked off on this board. So let's look at the section close to the BIOS battery. And there's nothing obvious here. And currently we are under the cover for one of the NVMEs. Let's see close to the power button here.
Is anything off here?
Okay, I don't see anything there. So let's go over to the CPU socket. So, right under this CPU socket, as you can see. Let's see now. A lot of thermal paste spilled. Which really doesn't make it any easier. But so far, looks fine. So many components here. But none of these look like they have been damaged in any way. Let's see, this is close to the top right. But doesn't seem to be any damage here. There's a lot of signaling going around here. So going over the right side where our 24-pin adapter is. Let's see if we can see anything here. And nothing obvious here. And after having checked all of that, I would like to go onto the backside of the board. So the backside basically has almost no components. The only real components I could see so far were the components of the backside of the PCH. which is right here. Most of these are capacitors, but there are some signaling resistors that are important, but I cannot see any damage here as well. So, out of curiosity, I went to the point in the board view where I saw that it's supposed to have a connection where the zero ohm resistor is supposed to be, because I couldn't find any damage on the backside. And look, let's have a look at this. Look at the power consumption now. We are at 80 milliamps that we've seen before. And look what happens when I connect with my tweezers these two points that I've been talking about. If I connect these two points, you see the RGB turns on and our power consumption goes high. And if I press the power button, we even have reaction to the power button as soon as I short these two. So it is yet another knocked off zero ohm resistor. But let's go under the microscope if you can actually see that there was something there or not. And now having a look at it, it's really hard to see, but it really looks like the lower pads at some point maybe had something on it. So I'm really indecisive here, to be honest, because I would expect it to be more obvious that there was a component between these two pads. Like, this looks like it had something on there, this looks like there was something on there, and this also looks a little bit like there was something on there. But it really isn't obvious, even under the microscope and even under heavy magnification, that there ever was a component there. But we've seen that there's physical damage on this board. Like, the damage that we've seen at the Ethernet controller where I've replaced that resistor right there. So yeah, let's put a zero ohm there and then have a look again. So same procedure as before. We take some flux. We use some leaded solder here. And there's our zero ohm resistor. And now, with one side tacked on, let's use hot air. Give it a little nudge, and now it should be properly connected. So, let's see now. Passive power consumption. We have 180 milliamps. We now have the LEDs on. And we have post LEDs right here, going from furthest down to upper. So we have DRAM, CPU, VGA, boot. We have a post screen connected. Let's press the power button. Let's see at the power consumption. And we already go to boot. This goes very fast. Wow. This board boots up instantly. We already have a BIOS screen and we have beeps. Very, very cool. Let's turn it off and let's populate this with a 2600 so that I can stress test it and also have 4 sticks of RAM into here. So now LINPACK has passed without any problems and a GPU can be connected to here. M.2 works and also the Ethernet works and the Wi-Fi, the audio works. And yeah, what can I say? I really got to admit, it was so lucky that I found that, because the area just looked like there was damage there. But those two pads really didn't look like there was a component there at any time. So it was really lucky that in the board view, that zero ohm resistor for that S5 state was there. Because as soon as I saw S5 state, I knew that could be something important for the board actually starting up. But I would have never guessed that there was a resistor there at one point. The solder pads looked so factory at that point, but It does make a lot of sense. Like I said, we had that knocked off 0-ohm resistor on the Ethernet connector a little bit more above. And it makes sense that, with all these scratches that we saw at the side, that there might be more physical damage. This was the case here. But yeah, most of the time when I get physical damage, it's a lot more obvious. Like, you could easily see that the pads had a resistor there before. Very often there's still the remains of a resistor there. But not this time. This time, yeah, this time it was a little bit harder to see that. But we got the board fixed. This is all that matters. It works now. It works properly. Reacts to the power button. Does whatever it needs to do. And yeah, all of my tools that you see in my videos are linked in the video description. Thank you so much. Hope you subscribe that you can see the next of my videos. Thank you very much for watching. This was Mainboard Medic. Bye.